Ooh, I've never pissed off. I've pissed off K-pop fans. I've never pissed off Star Wars fans.
Star Wars fans are fucking crazy.
I really want to know what you guys say. I can't wait for the hate. It's going to be great. That's the tagline. I'm going to put that. I can't wait for the hate. It's going to be great.
You should put some like
Tony the Tiger.
Yeah, with some frosted flakes on that motherfucker. Why? Okay, man. Let's go. Oh, that's like a premature nut.
Oh. Which pretty much sums up Star Wars The Last Jedi.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all, this is going to be a low budget ass. We just came out the theater review / post reaction to Star Wars The Last Jedi. And
It was dog shit. Okay.
Let's start off with the good. The good.
Camera
was
out of focus.
There the good.
Go. This is going to be low budget.
Yeah. Fuck you. Don't watch it then. Fuck off. Daisy Ridley. Good.
That Daisy Ridley.
Her character was good. Kylo Ren was good.
I like Kylo Ren.
He got swole. He got swole as fuck.
I
think the relationship between Daisy and Kylo was the only thing in this movie I was like, interested in.
I feel like there was some forced sexual tension between them.
Yeah, and you still don't find out who the fuck her parents are.
Like,
spoiler alerts, by the way.
Yeah. Okay. So, no, I said this as soon as we got into my truck. Had I not paid for this movie, I would have walked out.
Hell yeah.
This is comparable to Lamb Chop's The Song That Will Never End. Hold on! We done lost ya!
Oh, Disney is mad! They just knocked your shit out the window!
Woo! Kylo Ren coming! Kylo Ren coming! So we back. Yeah. We had some technical difficulties.
The force was mad at us.
Is Yoda behind us?
You guys, for real.
Dark shit that movie was.
If you're a Star Wars fan, we're huge Star Wars fan. If you're a Star Wars fan, definitely at least go give it a watch.
Yeah.
But
see what's going on there.
It was the most disjointed movie.
There were some fan services in there that you can tell they threw in just to keep people watching.
Well, yeah, for sure. There was a lot of the movie very, very closely mirrored the storyline of the Return of the Jedi. But it was just it was so disjointed. There was too many characters, there was too much going on, and it was not cohesive. There was so many dumbass, bullshit, fake tension-increasing plot moments, where they're like, no, they got Finn and Rose on the ground.
Let's
in the ship.
Let's do this, Chrome Dome.
They don't deserve a quick death. We're gonna make them suffer just long enough for them to be saved again. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, it was horrible.
The movie was terrible. There was the movie opens with this. There's a scene where this bombing ship is flying over the dreadnought.
Yeah.
It's the last one, right? Yeah. For some reason, none of the TIE fighters are blowing it up, yet they blew all the other ones up. And I can overlook that. It's a sci-fi. But she, for like 10 minutes, is kicking this damn staircase to get a controller to fall. And then when she...
And the time that it took for her to just keep kicking the motherfucker, she could have just ran up there, saved her own life.
Everything about this movie wasn't terrible. Bright moments.
There were.
And a few moments as a crazy Star Wars fan, where you're like, okay, why can't the whole movie be like this?
Oh my...
But the bulk of the movie was so bad.
There was
halfway through, we looked at each other and we're like,
oh my god,
this movie is absolutely terrible.
Yeah, during the movie we said
I wrote
that.
It off. Like...
We did. We stayed because we paid.
Yeah.
We're cheap. We stayed because we paid.
Yep.
That, and so we could tell you spoilers. The best part for me out of the entire movie, and I don't think all of you are going to be as fortunate enough for you to have it like we did, is a little kid on the top row yelling.
Yeah!
When Finn hit Captain Phasma in the face. Yeah. After he was knocked off of a thing and then magically came back on an elevator.
Where did
predictably
she come?
So.
Where did she come from?
So many characters
she
in this
movie.
She was
right there.
Yeah. So many characters come
and that's
up out
what Grindhog is.
Yeah. So many characters came out of nowhere in this movie. So many gigantic plot holes.
Where the fuck... Okay. Okay. So, their whole premise of leaving the end part, the little bunker, was, well, he came from somewhere. He used the Force.
Mm-hmm.
What if he didn't know that there was an opening? And he just led them to their more impending doom.
Again, giant plot hole. Like how, at the end, after Snoke is killed, and Kylo and Daisy have a little force battle and rip the lightsaber in half, Kylo's knocked unconscious, and we don't see Daisy again.
Nope. Until the
Millennium Falcon with the Wookiee. How did the Millennium Falcon get there? How did he pick her up? When did this occur? Which I could write all off, except when Kylo Ren wakes up, he says, "She took a ship." You're fucking unconscious. How do you know that? What bullshit?
Yeah, like how did she get off of what Snoke's main ship? You know, like,
yeah, that was ripped in half. I don't understand. The movie was it was such a disjointed fucking mess.
No joke. They had a cutscene. You see a character. It was 30 seconds long, not even. And they cutscene again, just to jump one more time.
Yeah,
it was like you could have gone without that.
Most people don't like. For some reason, movie studios think that most people
don't
like long movies.
We're used to cutscenes and it cutting fast. We watch K-pop.
Yeah,
for God's sakes. But no. Yeah,
it was a mess. There was a few moments where I was like, I got that, you know, that Star Wars feeling in your stomach. Where you're like, this is what I wanted. This is what I've been waiting for. I don't expect this movie to make me feel like I did when I was 8 and I saw Star Wars the first time. It's not going to happen again. I'm jaded and angry about life most of the time. But the small moments do not make up for the utter fucking cluster mess that this movie was.
There is going to be a part in the movie where you're like, all right, finally, some shit's going to go down.
Nope.
Yes!
I honestly, they could have made...
I'm trying not to give everything because there are some things that maybe they should...
Don't watch a spoiler review then.
All right, yeah, fuck it. He's a ghost. He's a motherfucking ghost.
Yeah.
It's not even a ghost.
He's astral planing himself.
With the Force.
Luke astral planes himself at the end of the movie to fight Kylo Ren.
Through light years.
And then disappears Yoda, Master Oogway style at the end of Kung Fu Panda. I don't know, man. I hope the next one's better. I know they're bringing back J.J. Abrams for the third one.
Oh, thank God.
So, I don't know. The last two Star Wars movies, I know a lot of people liked Rogue One, but Rogue One was
horrible.
Terrible, in my opinion.
Horrible movie.
This was... I won't say it's worse. I won't say it's worse because there were more moments in this movie that I enjoyed than the other movie, than Rogue One. But like I said in the beginning, Kylo Ren and Daisy Ridley's their dichotomy in the movie was the only bright spot that actually made sense. But the whole movie could have just easily been a training sequence where she learned to use her Jedi powers.
That's what I'm saying, and that's what I thought it lacked too.
All of a sudden,
at the very end, she's able to lift fucking tons of boulders and shit and just hold it there.
The whole movie was mostly the Rebels inexplicably being able to just slightly outrun
a fleet of the whole
movie focused.
Was
that
running?
It focused mainly on the Rebels. I don't want to see the Rebels.
You know what this reminds
That's
me of?
That's what Rogue One was. I want to see Jedi, damn it.
That movie had that feel to me. It's just like it went on and on and on. And we get it. They're barely escaping. They're out of fuel.
You know
all this other stupid, dumb shit. And also, why didn't she just tell him, oh, hey, yeah, we have a safe planet over there.
Exactly.
We're just going to go there.
The movie, imagine those movies. It's like a horror movie where you can strangle these dumbasses with a cordless phone. It's the same principle. Everybody in this movie makes the stupidest fucking decision at the exact right moment and then is magically saved by some other bullshit event just to make it exciting, but it wasn't. It was predictable boring. And boring. I didn't watch a single preview of this movie, and I went in with no expectations, aside from Star Wars-like expectations.
Although your prediction was wrong.
What was that? I thought Daisy Ridley was going to go bad. She was going to go evil. She still could, but I thought she was going to go evil. I assume, personally, that would have been a better way to take the movie if they flipped it. And then they brought her back at the end.
When they started showing, like, they made it seem like Kylo Ren was going to turn to the light side.
Yeah.
You know, but it's like, in my head, I was like, the only way for a true Sith to come to power is to kill his master.
Right.
Which he did.
That's how it works. So,
like, he wasn't trying to come. No, he was trying to gain power, which he clearly did. Not, like, physical, but status-wise.
Yeah. Anyway, guys, we'll stop ranting now. You know, don't take our words for it. Our recommendation is do not go see this movie.
Yeah.
But, obviously, it's Star Wars, and if somebody told me, don't go see this movie, I'm going to be like, fuck you, I don't know you, I'm going to go see this movie anyway. And then I'm going to be like, dude, those two fat fucks were right. I should listen to them.
Yeah.
But, you know what? Half the audience clapped. Half the audience clapped at the end of the movie. But, I don't know. Well, you guys let us know what you guys think, if you've already seen the movie.
And you're welcome for that image, by the way.
Yeah. And
that's what it is. That was
leave your
Star Wars.
Yeah. Leave your Star Wars angry K-pop fan rants below. And I look forward to reading all your hate. And I've pissed off K-pop fans. I've never pissed off Star Wars fans.
Star Wars fans are fucking crazy.
I really want to know what you guys say. I can't wait for the hate. It's going to be great. That's the tagline. I'm going to put that. I can't wait for the hate. It's going to be great.
You should put some like
Tony the Tiger.
Yeah, it was the Frosted Flakes on that motherfucker.